morning, children. Now we shall continue the lesson. The parrot who wouldn't talk. In the previous class, we came to know where they go to the parrot and how they were taken care. And the parrot was disliking its auntie Ruby. So the grandfather understood to feed the parrot to her, to the speaker, that is maybe a boy. So this he was taking care of the parrot. And he also was to have something to eat while he was feeding. So he was enjoying the life with the parrot. One afternoon, as I gave the parrot its lunch, I left the gate door open. Seconds later, the bird flew away to sit on the mango tree. As every day he was giving the food every morning, lunch, evening, like that he was giving. So what had happened? He left the cage door open. Here it is not an event. I forgot. That means maybe he has got purpose only. He left the cage without closing. It was open. So it flew and went as a mango tree. At the same time, grandmother came to the veranda and said, "I see your aunt's parrot has escaped." Grandmother came and told her, I see your aunt's parrot has escaped. I am very sorry, I said. I was staying very sad. I am very sorry. Aunt Ruby was upset. She wanted to buy another parrot. We promised to buy her a bowl of goldfish instead. She was very upset when it came. And they lost it. She was such a doll, she wants to buy again. Then they were promising her, we shall buy a bowl of goldfish instead. So she doesn't want to buy the goldfish and she was liking the parrot only. So, but the goldfish don't talk, said Aunt Ruby. She was telling goldfish, if the goldfish, I suppose you are saying, we can say small like aquarium. The box we can do it. So she was telling goldfish can't talk. Then neither did your bird, replied grandmother with a smile. Because as long as this was taking care, the bird never talk. So he was telling a joke. Neither did your bird, said grandfather. I thought that we would never see the parrot again. But maybe it missed the green chillies because a few days later, I found the bird sitting on the veranda, railing and looking at me. Unselfishly, I gave it half my mango. Because they thought that they would not see again because it flew away. Then, but some days back, after some days, what had happened? It missed the, it missed because these ones were feeding, giving the green chili, mango and the ripe tomato. So it was eating everything very happily. But once it got, it missed the feeds, you know. So a few days later, he found the bird sitting on the veranda railing. Railing is fence made of metal or wooden bars. Veranda, I mean, that is more circular, they are a little tight and keep it off. So they were keeping it. Fencing like a small sticks. So it came and sat on that. And looking at me, what it was doing? If the bird was looking at the writer. Unselfishly means in a way that shows that he cares about others and not just himself. Selfish means caring about oneself. Unselfish, opposite of selfish. Unselfishly. Okay? Without any selfish. He was not caring about himself. He was looking at the writer and the sitting. I gave it half of my mango. He was very interested to give any more. He was feeding it. So again he gave half mango. Just then Aunt Ruby came outside and cried out, "Look, it's my parrot. It must have missed me." So the same time she came out. Then she understood that it is her parrot. What she is telling? It might have missed me. So she was very happy. She was telling it might have missed me. So it came to see me. With a loud squawk, the parrot flew to the nearest rose bush. It looked angrily at my aunt and shrieked, "You are useless. can't talk, can't sing, can't dance.
From this word, from this sentence, where it came?
Because when this aunt got angry, Aunt Ruby got angry, while it pushed her spectacle, with the angry she told, you are useless, can't talk, can't sing, can't dance. So, what the parrot gave to her? Kiba. At the same time, and then the master gave the parrot to her. So, it flew away, and it, then it has two meanings around it. Squawk. What is squawk meaning? A loud and a rough sound made by the parrot. You know how it makes squawk, squawk. That is the crying of parrot. Then, shrieked. Shrieked means spoke in a loud, high voice. Shrieked. It is not saying very slowly, but it was very loud voice. It is saying that sentence. And Ruby turned ruby red and ran inside. When she got angry, what will be her expression? She might have got such angry. So her face became red and ran inside. She went inside. The parrot became a regular visitor to our garden. Regular visitor, it comes daily. It was coming again every day. So it was regularly, it was coming in their garden. Whenever it saw Aunt Ruby, it would call out, "You are useless, can't do, can't sing, can't dance." So, whenever the bird see the ant is coming out or passing back through the way, it was saying, "You are useless, you can't do, can't sing, can't dance." The parrot had learned to talk after all. Anyway, as long as the parrot was in their house, it doesn't talk. But if it does not know how can it talk after this, it was angry, so it did not talk. But once it out of the cage, it started to talk. But after this lesson, what we can understand? When we do good, if she gets angry, if she is saying a good sentence, a good word to the parrot, it could have repeated the same. What we give, we get it back. If we be good to others, if we behave good way to the others, we may get it by good. If we use bad word and bad way if we behave, we may be also getting it by. Okay, children, we have completed the second lesson. In that, read and see the lessons, meanings, and now try to understand the lesson by reading again. Then in the day, page number 60, there is a writing skill is there. I think you can do some work these days. So, page number 60. In the writing, one form is there for you. In the first one. Now imagine that you are a caged animal or bird. Use the points from the discussions and write a paragraph on your feelings and how you managed to escape from the cage. This is work for you. The first one. Only one you write. First one. You imagine that you are a bird. Then you need to write this story, but you can create it in another story. Write one paragraph in your rough book and come to the class. Okay, thank you, children. Bye.